So I'm a teacher seven, Mr. Barry here. In this short mini lesson, I want to look at the Intel Core i9 and see, is it worth it? I'm also going to compare that to the latest Intel Core i7s. So let's get started with the mini lesson. Well, here we see at the very top is the actual box that you get with the Core i9 Extreme there. And below that is a table showing all the current Core i9 processors. The very top there, you can actually see we're looking at the name, the price, the CPU performance mark, the CPU value, and the value is calculated by taking the performance and dividing it by the price, and then the single thread mark. The pass mark single thread CPU test only runs one stream of instructions rather than multiple parallel streams per core. The majority of consumer applications, such as MS Word, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, and most games, although multi-threaded, rarely utilize more than one thread at a time. So this test can be seen as a reasonable real-world test for typical consumer workloads. The single thread value, and also the TDP, which is the thermal design power, or the amount of heat that it puts out there. And then we have the power performance, as well as when it was tested by CPUBenchmark.net, which is an excellent resource to go to. And then we also have what kind of socket they fit into. Notice that all of these fit into the socket 2066. We'll start with the 7900X, running at 3.3 gigahertz. The price is just shy of $1,000, and the CPU benchmark is at $22,669. With a value at 23.37. The next thing that you see there is the single thread mark at 25.32. Then the single thread value at 2.6. It's putting out 140 watts of power. The performance is 161. The next one here is the 7920. This one will cost you at $1,130. The CPU performance mark is at just a little bit higher at 23,291. The CPU value is at 20.61. So you notice it's starting to go down. With each faster processor and more expensive processor, you're paying more money for the performance that you're getting there. Next, we have the single thread mark. That's at 2511, a little bit less. And then the single thread value, it drops significantly there at 2.22, and it puts out the same amount of heat. So the type of CPU heatsink and fan that you would purchase could be either for that first model or that second one. And then we notice that the power performance is a little bit higher at 166. Next one down is the 7940X. This one would set you back at $1,400. And the performance mark is 24,727. The value drops again to 17.67, and the single thread mark is at 2553. Single thread value at down there only to 1.83. So you're paying a lot for that performance, is what that's telling you. And the amount of heat it puts out is a lot, 165 watts of heat. So you'd have to buy a larger heatsink and fan for these last three than you would for the first two. And then the power performance is down there to only 149. Interesting. Next is the Intel Core i9-7960X running at 2.8 gigahertz. Your price there is very close to $1,800. And the performance is up there, 25,364. The CPU value drops down to less than 15. It's now down to 14.21. And the single thread mark is down there to only 2411. The single thread value is really low, only 1.35. And then again, it's putting out a lot of heat, and the power performance is at 153. And then the last one on our chart is the one that just came out the other day. It is the Intel Core i9-7980XE running at 2.6 gigahertz, and it cost you $2,000. Now, I just saw this one on sale at Newegg, and it was just a little bit above 2000, and I think Amazon was just a few dollars less at around $1,999. The CPU performance mark is at 27,402. CPU value is down there to only 13.71. That means you're paying a tremendous amount there for each of that performance marks. And the single thread mark is down to only 2,238. Single thread value is terrible at only 1.12. And you'll need a very large heatsink and fan for that one at 165 TDP. And then the power performance is 166. Here's some information on the Intel Core i9 X series, and this is specifically towards the Core i9-7980XE, the one that just came out. Going on, let's find these at Newegg. You'll find the Core i9-7900X, there it is, just shy of $1,000. It's using the Skylake core, and it is a 10-core processor. The next one we have there on top of the list is going for $1,200. That's the Intel Core i9-7920X. Again, it's using the Skylake core with 12 cores running at 2.9 gigahertz. Then we have the next one there is at $1,800, and that is the Intel Core i9-7960X. And then the last one there is at $2,100, and that is the Intel Core i9-7980XE. Let's compare these with the latest Intel Core i7s, the Coffee Lake processors, the new ones that just came out here the last few weeks. The very first one I have there is something that stands out right away to me and you, I'm sure, is the price. It's only one third the price of the cheapest of the Core i9 processors. I wonder how that's going to come out to the value there. I'm sure it's going to make it a better value. The very first one we see there is the Intel Core i7-8700 Coffee Lake with 6 cores running at 3.2 gigahertz, and it fits on the 1151 sockets. And then the last one that we have there for the Coffee Lakes is the Intel Core i7-8700K. That means it's unlocked. You can overclock this thing, and it runs at 3.7 gigahertz. And it could probably be overclocked to beyond the 4 gigahertz range. Again, it is going to fit into the socket 1151. Remember, that is the 300 series motherboards, and it's putting out 95 watts of heat. And that one's just shy of $400. So now let's look at this chart that I created. This at the top part, this is the same chart that we just saw a few seconds ago. But below that, we've incorporated the Intel Core i7-8700 running at 3.2 gigahertz. And that one, you can find it as cheap as $312 from such places as Amazon and eBay. CPU benchmark is there at 15,241. CPU value is way up there. Look at that, 48.85. It blows all the others away for value. Then the single thread mark is at 2537, again, higher than many of those. The single thread value is 8.13, which is far better for value we saw earlier. The heat that it puts out is only 65 watts, so this one could take a much smaller heat sink and fan unit. Not going to break the bank on you there. And then the power performance is way up there at 234. And these processors, again, now just came out. And remember, they take the 1151 socket, but they are going with the 300 series chipsets. So the question comes up, well, is it worth it? Well, when you look at the tables and you look at the performance of all of these, I would say, is the Intel Core i9 worth it? The answer is no. Which one would I recommend? I would recommend going with the Intel Core i7 8700 3.2 gigahertz at $320, or you could go with the unlocked version, close to $400 there for the Intel Core i7-8700K. For the games that we have out today, I believe your best value would be found in the Core i7 processors today. So there you have it. I hope that answered your questions on, is the Core i9 processors, are they worth it to buy it today? If you're watching this on YouTube, please give it a thumbs up, share, and I'd love to see your comments for the discussion. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.